And welcome to another awesome video inside the media cabinet. My name is Joey, and thank you for joining me for this awesome video. Today, I thought I would show off a little bit of my first book haul of 2022. Don't got a lot of titles to show off, but I got some free awesome novelizations to show off to you guys. And I'm also going to do a one-page preview of each of the books that I picked up. Before I start this video, if you clicked on this video, it means you have a huge interest in movie novelizations or media tie-in books. And if those are some of your favorite types of books to read, then you definitely want to check out the Paper Movies Novelization Book Club. I'm going to drop the Facebook page and the YouTube channel in the description box, and also check out Matthew on The Geek's Attic and Adam on Brian VRM. That's two of their channels. There's also another awesome guy on there. He has a channel. His name is Jeremy. And he's on a channel called Stupid Chainsaw Productions. So he is the third member of the Paper Movies Novelization Book Club. So every month they pick a movie novel, they read it, and then at the end of the month they discuss about it. So with all that being said, let's get into this little haul, we'll get started. First book, based off of the blockbuster action video game, the official prequel by David Liss, we have Spider-Man Hostile Takeover. Nice, beautiful cover, nice action shot of Spider-Man, nice, beautiful red spine and back of the book. This is from Titan Books. I own a couple of Titan books, so I'm no stranger to these Titan novels. So let's jump in to the one-page preview for Spider-Man Hostile Takeover. Chapter 1. New York City had everything, and that was usually a plus, but not so much when that something was a snake store. Or was it still a plus? Maybe the weird, gross, and possibly dangerous implications of a shop dedicated to limbless reptiles embodied everything he loved about this city, Spider-Man mused as he swung through an open story second window. He planned to land on the floor, but it was already occupied, so at the last moment he performed an in-air flip and clung to the ceiling, staring down at dozens of hissing, slithering creatures. He'd set up his computer to monitor emergency channels and then alert him when they picked up anything where he might make a difference. Fires, robberies, and the all-too-frequent appearances of villains doing super bad things. He also played with the coding to catch anything that might be, well, amusing. It was Saturday night, and his girlfriend Mary Jane was off doing something she didn't want to tell him about, and he wanted to be diverted to. So, snakes. He'd chosen snakes, and he'd gotten snakes. There was a lesson in there somewhere. He thought maybe that when life gave you options, it was best to choose more carefully. And that is the one-page preview of Spider-Man Hostile Takeover. And with that, we move on to our next novel. Hollywood, 1969. You should have been there. And with that, we have a novel by Quentin Tarantino. We have Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. And on the front, you have a picture of Margot Robbie, Brad Pitt, and Leonardo DiCaprio. And then on the back, you have another montage of some great pictures from the movie. This is a Harper Pernano book, I believe. So, haven't seen the movie. I've wanted to see this movie. It's got some great free actors in it. So, and with that, here is our one-page preview of Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. Chapter 1, Call Me Marvin. The buzzer on Marvin Schwartz's desk, dictaphone, makes a noise. The William Morris agent's finger holds the lever down on the box. Is that my 10:30 you're buzzing me about, Miss Himmelstein? Yes, it is, Mr. Schwartz, his secretary's voice pipes out of the tiny speaker. Mr. Dalton is waiting outside. Marvin pushes down the lever again. I'm ready when you are, Mrs. Himmelstein. When the door to Marvin's office opens, his young secretary, Mrs. Himmelstein, steps in first. She's a 21-year-old woman of the hippie persuasion. She sports a white miniskirt that shows off her long tan legs and wears her long brown hair in Pocahontas-style pigtails that hang down each side of her head. The handsome 42-year-old actor Rick Dalton and his D-regular glistening western brown pompadour follow behind her. Marvin's smile grows wide as he stands up from the chair behind his desk. Miss Himmelstein tries to do the introductions, but Marvin cuts her off. Mrs. Himmelstein, since I just finished watching Rick Dalton, I'm not going to say this last word, but we'll say effing. Let's do that. And that's the end of the one-page preview for Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. I know a lot of people were surprised when they actually made a book for this. I mean, Quentin Tarantino is an amazing director and actor. He you know, he's up there with, like, Martin Scorsese. So get this book if you're interested in it. And the final book in this haul and little preview, a major motion picture from Paramount Pictures, a novel by Alan Dean Foster, written by Roberto Orci and Alex Crossman, based upon Star Trek, created by Gene Roddenberry. We have the novelization for the 2009 Star Trek, starring Quentin Tarantino, Zoe Saldana, and Chris Pine. Star Trek. Now, I will say, in ordering and getting this, I did go on to Amazon. I will be getting some more books soon. I'm not going to say what the books are. I don't want to give it away. But I will be doing a video when I get those. And I also shout out to Adam from Paper Movies Novelization. They had a live stream last night. And I won the two giveaways that they were doing, Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves, and Jaws 2. So I will be doing a video when I get those. And with that being said, let's do our one-page preview for Star Trek. The star was a supergiant, and very old. Over billions of years, the forces that had powered it throughout its long life had finally exhausted themselves. Now it was falling in upon itself. The cataclysmic gravitational collapse triggered the spectacular explosion known as a supernova. What was left at the core of the supergiant was a neutron star, cold and dense and dead. Everything else was blown outward, creating a brilliantly glowing shock wave traveling at nearly a tenth the speed of light that swept up everything in its path. For a day or two, this supernova remnant would shine more brightly than any other corner of the galaxy. A star had died elsewhere in the cosmos. It is an unremarkable corner of one galaxy arm. A child was born. Such in the balance of existence. Though his arrival was considerably less dramatic than the passing of the supergiant, it was in its own way no less remarkable. As some stars had unusual origins, so too did the squalling infant. At the moment, this was not a concern. And that is our one-page preview of Star Trek. So, looking forward to reading this one. Love the newer Star Trek movies, so... Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. This is something that I do every single time when I get a new book. I read out loud and I do a one-page preview read, so I thought I would do that for you guys. Let me know what you guys thought about in the comments, and like I said, I will be putting the links to everybody that I mentioned in the description below. If you, yes, you, the one watching this video, likes everything that is dedicated to media, whether it be video games, movie novelizations, or movies, make sure to hit that subscribe button, drop a like, and if you liked anything that I mentioned in this video, make sure to leave a comment. Also, make sure to check out some of my other videos. My last video was an unboxing of Halloween Kills, the Best Buy exclusive steelbook, and I also showed off my Halloween movie collection. So, with all that being said, thank you very much for watching this video, and I'll see you guys next time in the media cabinet. Bye bye.